بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، ثم الصلاة والسلام على نبي الأمين محمد بن عبد الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين وعلى كل من تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وبعد. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الذين قالوا ربنا الله ثم استقاموا تتنزل عليهم الملائكة ألا تخافوا ولا تحزنوا وأبشروا بالجنة التي كنتم توعدون. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Dear brothers and sisters, welcome to our last and final reminder for this year Ramadan 2020 from Muslim Council of Hong Kong. As we all know, sadly, Ramadan is ending for this year. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam informed us that at the beginning of the month of Ramadan, when the hilal of Ramadan is sighted, the devil, Shaitan, will be chained. As Ramadan ends, we sight the hilal of Shawwal, Ramadan, Shaitan will be released as Ramadan ends. Subhanallah. This is now the time when Muslims should be much more alert, be much more aware that Shaitan will come back with full force, trying to undermine you, make you lose all the reward or the good deeds you have accumulated during this blessed month of Ramadan. May Allah help us to safeguard these our good deeds. Basically, we have learned, we have put into practice submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have learned to control our wishes and desires in order to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during this month of Ramadan. We have acquired some skills in terms of self-discipline, in terms of taqwa. We should put this into practice for the rest of the 12 months before the next Ramadan, inshallah ta'ala. Never let Shaitan, who is the open enemy, whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has warned us about in multiple places in the Quran. For instance, in Surah Yasin, chapter 36 of the Quran, ayah 60 and 61, Allah is reminding us, the children of Adam, have I not warned you that not to follow Shaitan or to worship him? Because here, worship, it means we leave the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we follow the command of Shaitan or anybody affiliated to Shaitan. Anything that is taking us from worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this become worshipping something else other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah. May Allah preserve and protect us. In the following ayat 61, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that we should worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. That is the right path. So Muslims, we should remain steadfast. As Allah commanded us in Surah Fussilah, He said, those who believe and remain firm, Allah will send angels at the time of death to give them glad tidings of entry to Jannah. The role of these angels at the time of death is to give us, the believers, assurance, give you comfort that you are indeed, we are your companion in this life, we will be your companion in the grave, we will be your companion in the hereafter. So rest assured, have tranquility. So Muslims should have peace and tranquility. Never let Shaitan make you feel that you have committed so many sins that Allah will not forgive you. Allah mentioned in the Quran in Surah Zumar, chapter 39 of the Quran, ayah 53, O my servant who have wronged themselves, never despair of the mercy of Allah. He forgives all sins. He is indeed the one who forgives sins. So we should always repent. Whenever we make mistake, whenever we err, whenever Shaitan overcome us, we should go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is an authentic narration reported by Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu anhu in the Musnad of Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal rahimahullah ta'ala rahmatan wasiya. Shaitan came declaring to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, O Allah, my Lord, by your glory I will mislead them. As long as the soul will remain in their body. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in return by His mercy, said, I will continue to forgive them as long as they seek for forgiveness. Subhanallah. So we should always ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us, to guide us. We should also take the steps to remain steadfast. That is to keep the good company, to keep the good practice. What we been learning through the month of Ramadan, that is our night prayer, fasting Mondays and Thursdays, fasting the white days, fasting the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. Be in good company of Muslims. Whenever you are not sure of anything about your deen, ask someone who has knowledge. Jazakumullah khairan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us, bless us with another Ramadan and many more Ramadan with good health and iman. Because we are sure among us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take some before the next month of Ramadan. We are not praying for it, but this is the fact of the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has appointed a specific time for each one of us to live on this earth. It will not be added, it will not be subtracted. Among us, those who will pass away, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we ask you to forgive them. And those who will remain, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continue to guide them to overcome shaitan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you all, accept all our worship. May Allah give us good health, protect us against all the harmful viruses around and any other disease. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us and all Muslims against the insinuation of shaitan. May Allah bless us, accept from every one of us. Jazakumullah khairan, barakallahu feekum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
My Allah is the one, the one, the one, the one.